Hey everyone, yesterday I was really excited because my Ryzen 7800X3D CPU had finally arrived, and so I installed it in this system, booted up, and then I was one key press away from losing access to everything. That's because in August I wanted to play the Battlefield 6 open beta, and when I went to play it I had a warning saying the secure boot was off, and you can't play the game without secure boot being on. So I went into my BIOS, I enabled it, I disabled CSM, and then I booted up into Windows and I played the game and had loads of fun. However, by enabling secure boot, that set off a chain of events without my knowledge due to a Windows update from last year that meant the BitLocker encryption got turned on without my consent. And so when I swapped out the CPU, a message came up that basically said, you know, press Y to continue. But if I'd pressed Y to continue in a hurry, then I would have been completely locked out of my system and lost loads of data. And this was all because I wanted to play Battlefield 6's open beta. And, you know, I should say before I get loads of weird YouTube comments, I should say that actually I'm responsible for my computer. All I did was enable secure boot. I did not enable BitLocker, but nonetheless, you know, I am responsible for my system. I'm responsible for knowing what settings I've enabled, and I should in theory check about BitLocker encryption before I swap out my CPU. So I should have done that and I didn't. But if you did want to play Battlefield 6 or Blop 7 or Valorant, which all require secure boot, then you might actually be hit by the same issue that I was very nearly hit with and completely locked out of your system and you could lose everything. So I wanted to do this video and talk about that and talk about ways you can protect yourself. But first I need to actually back up a little bit and talk about three really important terms, which is TPM, secure boot, and BitLocker, which are three completely different things and technologies, but they are also very interdependent and interconnected. So firstly, TPM, what is that? Well, that stands for Trusted Platform Module, and it's literally a physical chip with on your motherboard that provides lots of cryptographic and security features. So then within Windows, if you want, you know, your disk and your data to be encrypted, then Windows can actually use that actual physical module on your motherboard to help with the data encryption. So that is TPM, and that is a requirement of Windows 11 nowadays. Next, we come to secure boot, and what that is when you boot up your computer, it runs through a UEFI startup process, and if you've got some sort of virus or malware, what could actually happen is you could have like a kernel level rootkit or malware that literally would be running at your computer's, you know, startup level, and then whether you use Windows or Linux, that rootkit could actually be there causing of harm or, you know, tracking you and things like that. So secure boot actually stops that. And that is actually something that game developers really like as well, because it can stop certain cheats. So kernel level cheats cannot run if you've got secure boot enabled. And that's why Battlefield 6, Blop 7, and Valorant are actually saying that you need secure boot to be on. And next we come to BitLocker encryption. And this is actually a feature developed by Microsoft. It's within Windows, and basically you can turn it on and encrypt your data and your disk. So basically if then somebody stole your laptop or your computer or even just your NVMe drive, then the thief can't actually do anything because the drive is encrypted and completely inaccessible without entering a really long recovery key. So those are the three really important things: TPM, secure boot, and BitLocker encryption. And they are a good thing. But what is not good is, in my opinion, how the game developers and Microsoft have actually worked together to create this really dangerous combination with good intentions, but that could see you actually completely locked out of your system. And that's what almost happened to me. And that's because Windows last year had an update called the 24H2 update on Windows 11. And basically, amongst loads of other updates, they actually sort of soft enabled BitLocker. So what that meant is that if you've got an existing Windows install, you could actually find the BitLocker is enabled but inactive, and that's a really key point that I'm going to come back to. So without your knowledge, BitLocker could be sort of soft set up, but you'd have to click a button to fully activate it. The thing is, I'm not against Microsoft enabling BitLocker by default, because that can be a good thing. Like, I recently bought a Dell laptop, and it would be really easy for a thief to steal that and then access all of my data if BitLocker wasn't around by default. And with my Dell laptop, my actual BitLocker recovery key got automatically backed up. However, that did not happen with this computer. This computer was a brand new 2025 build. It had all the latest Windows updates and things like that, and BitLocker encryption was off. You know, I never enabled it on here, so even though I had a Microsoft account, it was always off. But then when I actually went to play Battlefield 6's open beta, I needed secure boot to be on. So I went into the BIOS, and in my Gigabyte motherboard, it basically said that secure boot was enabled but not active. And what you've got to do with many Gigabyte motherboards is reset the factory keys. That's the step that even Gigabyte tell you to do if you want secure boot to be on. So I'd done that, and then I booted up, and I never had any prompts about BitLocker encryption or anything else. But because of the Windows update from the end of last year, that actually set up BitLocker and turned it on my computer without my knowledge and my consent. I do not remember opting into that. I'm like 99.999% sure of that. And because of that, I never then backed up my Windows recovery key, because why would I need to? You know, I never remember opting into it. All I wanted to do was play Battlefield 6. I didn't even know the BitLocker was on, and so I never backed up my recovery key. I've been building computers for 2 decades, and if Windows had actually popped up and said, hey, you've got BitLocker on, but you haven't backed up your recovery key, do you want to do that now on this computer? Then I would have done that, and then I would have cursed Microsoft for enabling it without my permission. But because that never happened, I literally didn't know I had BitLocker enabled. So then when I had my new CPU, yesterday I went to install it, and I almost got completely and utterly screwed, because when I actually booted everything back up, my BIOS said something about, you know, fTPM being changed and the keys being different, and press Y to continue. And there was more to the error message, which I did end up reading, and then it triggered something in my head that said, you know, do not press Y, that could be a very bad thing. Because, you know, I knew I hadn't enabled BitLocker encryption, but because I'd reset the factory keys to play Battlefield 6's open beta, I thought, is there actually a chance that my NVMe drives have been encrypted, you know, without my knowledge? So what I then did was actually pull out my two NVMe drives, and I used an NVMe USB adapter to hook it up to my laptop, and that's when I noticed that, yes, BitLocker encryption was on. So basically, if I'd booted up my computer and pressed Y on the message that came up, then the factory keys would have been reset again, and I would have been locked out of everything. But thankfully, by noticing that error, what I could do was shut down my system, and then I swapped out to the old CPU, which allowed me to boot up back into Windows, and then I could back up my recovery key. And, you know, this is all a complete mess. All I wanted to do in August was play Battlefield 6's open beta. I never opted into BitLocker. You know, I reset the keys within the Gigabyte motherboard. It didn't say anything about BitLocker encryption, because that's a feature within Windows, not the BIOS, so I never even thought that Windows would spontaneously decide to enable BitLocker encryption by me enabling secure boot. But anyway, the fact that I did catch that error was a good thing, because it meant that I could then, you know, back up my recovery key, then I could shut down, swap out my CPU yet again, and then I could actually boot up and recover my system via the BitLocker recovery key, which was a complete pain, and it took many hours. And I'm quite a technical person. I've built dozens of computers, I've been working on them for decades, but actually the average user won't know how to do all of that and won't have the, you know, confidence or knowledge or expertise to actually do all of that. And as I mentioned at the start of this video, I think it's completely crap that actually, you know, whilst Windows and the game developers are trying to push people towards a more secure future with TPM and secure boot and BitLocker, you know, in practice something is going wrong. And it might actually be that Gigabyte are at fault here as well, because I have noticed with a lot of the how to enable secure boot, you know, guides out there, Gigabyte do stand out as a bit of an outlier, because you often have to reset the factory keys. And it's my hunch that enabling that, when combined with that Windows 11 update from the end of last year, those two factors are the things that enabled BitLocker encryption. If I'm wrong, please do leave me a comment. But just in general, you know, I'm on my Windows 11 machine, and it's constantly spamming me with adverts for like Game Pass and crap like that. Why doesn't it come up and say, hey, you have BitLocker encryption enabled without your knowledge? Do you want to back up your recovery key so you're not completely screwed if you change a bit of hardware? That might actually be a good idea. And with Battlefield and Blop 7 and Valorant and stuff, when you actually play in that game, why can't it pop up, you know, just in the menu and say, hey, you've got BitLocker encryption enabled, make sure you've backed up your recovery key. In my opinion, you know, if Microsoft and these games are going to force us down that path, then they should be prompting us and reminding us about the recovery key and things like that. So, rant almost over. If you did want to play those games, and you know you're now completely worried about secure boot and being locked out of your system, what can you do to protect yourself? Well, there's a few things. Firstly, whenever you're going to change a bit of hardware, you should always go into the BitLocker feature on Windows and see if BitLocker is enabled. And if it is, you should then back up your recovery key. You can back it up to your Microsoft account, and I'd suggest either putting on a USB or even printing it out on a bit of paper, or doing all of them, because your BitLocker recovery key is incredibly important. It's quite literally the key to your entire computer. Next up, make sure you've got backups, because whilst I do have offsite backups, there were a few days out of date, which again is entirely my fault. But because they were a few days out of date, if I'd just got locked out of my system, I would have had to reinstall my operating system, reinstall all of my games, and then, you know, bring my remote backups back, which would have taken a day or two, and they would have been a few days out of date anyway, so I would have lost some work. So hopefully this video has helped you. If you've got any further questions, please leave a comment. If you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button, and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.